Okay, so you were asked to look at a general permutation matrix and to look and see what that does to a vector x. Now, if we apply the permutation matrix to x, where the permutation matrix is defined by this integer vector right here, then we saw that the rows in that permutation matrix become the unit basis vectors ordered in the indicated order in this integer vector. And we have learned how to do a partition matrix multiply. In this case, this is a matrix partitioned by rows, and this actually is a vector viewed as a matrix that isn't partitioned at all. And if we then multiply that out, we get this right here. But notice that this right here we saw in a previous homework exercise simply picks out the indicated component of vector x and so forth. So what you get is the vector with its components reshuffled in the order indicated by our permutation vector. Similarly, you can look and see what happens when you apply a permutation matrix to a matrix A. If we start by partitioning the matrix into rows, then if we apply the permutation matrix to it, then we get this right here. Again, we can do partition matrix multiplication to get to that point, and then we can recognize that each of these simply picks out the appropriate row, and you notice that all that happens is that the rows of matrix A are reshuffled. Next, we have this exercise that illustrates what happens when you apply the transpose of matrix P, a permutation matrix, to a matrix A from the right. Why don't you go ahead and do that problem, and then we'll get back together in the next video.